Welcome back to Let's Play the Charnel House Trilogy, now to embark on the third and final installment, Exhale. Let's check it out. I'm not really going to thoroughly recap what happened in the first one, but... Well, in the first one, Alex was planning on going... I'm just going to quickly recap. Alex was planning on going on a trip. She got on a train and... There was a man in her apartment who kept appearing with thunder and stuff like that. He was very spooky looking. And she's going to this place. I don't remember what the name of the place is called. But then the second one has this guy, damn, I forget his name, I'm really sorry. English accent guy, and find out he goes around and there's food, and there's a bartender, and there's a ticket man, and then something happens, and then the ticket man is dead, stuffed in a bag, and so is the bartender, and the food is like years old or something. Very strange. Anyway, Exhale. Maybe this will make a little more sense to us. Hoping this picks back up with Alex. I missed her in the second installment. Here she is. Now we're in Earth.
I'm so bored. Wish I hadn't given that dude my book.
Harold.
I never even caught his name.
Harold something.
That was pretty rude of me, actually. I should have asked. Maybe I'll go find him. Whoa. God damn. We've only been traveling for half an hour.
Just have a watch.
Felt like a lot longer. Still got most of the journey left. I wonder if there are any other stops. I'd kill for a cigarette. I should go stretch my legs, see if that train dude's around, ask him where the other guy's cabin is, or just see if there's a bar.
There is, I think. Could be with rotted food or food that's completely fine. The guy's name is Floyd. Like the guy's name is Lloyd, a bartender in The Shining. Yeah. So I got stuff. We got pictures, seats, and stuff like that. We have purse, ticket, cigarette pack, lighter.
Cards, money, mace, the usual. My train tickets. I'd like to say smoking is my only vice, but it's not.
The other is Neil Gaiman novels.
My trusty lighter. 10 years old and still going strong.
Now, the guy who was appearing in her apartment is in one of these rooms. I forget. It's either 1C or 2C. I forget which one.
A cute doggy! He looks like my model dog. Wait, where did I leave that? Oh, crap.
The ticket maker guy picked it up. You dropped it.
I don't think I should steal it.
Okay, so when... Harold Lang, now I remember his name, was running around. The windows were always closed, and by the time he figured out to, you know, how to open the windows, we found out it was just earth. It was, the windows were covered with earth, and he opened it and some of these, of the dirt came spilled inside, and then he couldn't breathe, there was no air, and then he blacked out or something, or died. Or he was already dead, I don't even know.
We're moving fast. The snowy countryside is beautiful. I don't recognize where we are. I'd freeze to death if I opened the window. It's cold enough on this train.
Still wonder why she didn't bring some kind of a coat. Especially when her ex-boyfriend had a coat. She could have just borrowed it.
Nice, comfy seats. I've been sitting down long enough. Nice, I've been...
Just want to see if she'd say something different.
A portrait of a sickly-looking guy in a hat. I wonder who this is. I don't think I should steal it.
Steal everything. Okay.
The door leading out of my compartment. A fire extinguisher. Can be used for putting out fires or dispersing rowdy parties.
Oh. Is that often done, I wonder?
Nothing's burning just now. This door leads into the next carriage. I can see that conductor down at the other end. I should talk to him first.
Okay.
A compartment door. I can't hear anything. I don't want to just go knocking on any old door.
I didn't say knock on it. Open it. Here's the picture of the old train from looks like centuries ago, yet somehow is also this train. At least that's what we saw on the first...
A steam train. It looks exactly like the one I'm on. Maybe it is. There's a plaque at the bottom. It says Old Gloria's inaugural trip, December 1988.
Well, that's not locked long. That's not that long ago. Now, when Harold Lang looked at the picture, it looks centuries old. And he couldn't believe that it was the same train as the one that they were on.
I have no desire to carry a picture of a train around. A compartment door. I can't hear anything. I don't... When I saw him earlier, I thought he was old. But no, he just has white hair. Now I look at him properly, he seems kind of familiar.
Okay, so to Harold, he's old. Well, actually, he didn't look old to Harold. But he acted old. Engine room door?
This door leads to the engine room in the cab. I wonder what the driver's like. Actually, do I really want to know?
What does it matter?
I probably shouldn't go in there. Besides, it's almost certainly locked.
Hmm.
Hey!
Evening, lassie. How's old Gloria treating you so far?
Gloria?
The train, lass. Old girl just had a service. It's like lying on air, isn't it?
It's... she's... kind of ancient, right?
You could say that. Been running well over 100 years, so she has.
Idiot.
Of course, she's had every part replaced more than once.
So she's not really the same train at all, then?
She's got the same heart, though. Anyway, you youngins don't want to be listening to all going on about history. I already talked that museum doctor's ear off.
Oh, no. Not at all. I'm fascinated by the past, actually. When I was younger, me and my friend used to go out in the countryside looking for old bits and pieces. Had a big collection.
Oh, aye. I used to be a bit of a mudlarker myself, actually.
Mudlarker? Isn't that a type of bird?
Aye, so it is. But it's also the name we give to people who wander around the shores of rivers and sea banks, picking up all manner of old tat. I found myself some pretty rare stuff back in the day, so I did.
Old tat?
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Oh, just the usual stuff. Found an old tin of photos once, though. That was a fun time. So, anything I can help you with, miss?
Alright, we've got a bunch of choices here. Ask about the journey.
You make this journey a lot?
Aye. More than I care to remember, actually. Aye, sure enough.
It's pretty unusual to find such a late-night route, right? I was surprised when I saw it.
Aye. I like the night shift. Nice and quiet. Less so tonight, mind. The doctor's been up and down like a yo-yo. He won't sit still. Surprised he's not out roaming the corridors right now, actually. Still, he did get me a sniff of whiskey. Can't complain.
Sorry, I can go back to my compartment if you'd like.
No, not at all. I've already had my nap. The more the merrier, I say. And I'm sure Floyd would be happy to see you as well.
So he talks to Lang. First he says there's Floyd, and then there is... Floyd didn't even show up today. So I don't know what's going on with Harold there. What about the destination?
So, the port town we're headed to...
Aye. Quaint little Nibbawamset.
Huh.
There's nothing to see there. Nothing at all.
Don't any of the bigger port towns have boats to Augur Peak?
Nope. Just that one place. Not exactly a popular tourist destination.
You ever been yourself?
Augur Peak? Aye, plenty. I live there, after all.
Oh, so you'll be crossing with us?
Aye, got some time off.
You got family there?
Aye, my wife's over on the island. She misses old Don when he's gone.
Hmm. So he is saying he's old, and... he's saying that the train is at least 100 years? 100 years or over 100 years? But this says, didn't it say inaugural, you know, voyage or something like that? 1988? So unless the current year is 2088 in this story, ask about the museum doctor, yeah.
So you say the other guy's a doctor, huh?
Aye. Off to Ogre to dig around in the ruins. I had no idea my old home island had any historical secrets like that. Here. It's funny, isn't it? You, me, and him. All with an interest in archaeology.
Wait. His name isn't, Howard or something, is it?
Harold Lang, if I'm thinking right. Why? Do you know him?
Friend of a friend. That's so weird. I had no idea when I met him on the station.
Oh, yeah, though.
Life can be strange sometimes. Aye?
Oh, don't. You'll be saying it's fate next. Maybe we're all set to discover some great treasure on the island. Actually, it's funny. It's not just us, either.
Oh?
Yeah, my friend Kat. She's on the island. She's Dr. Lang's assistant. Hmm. I've heard a fair bit about him. He seems different.
Yeah.
Aye, they all do, don't they?
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, you know, all these young men these days.
Huh. Yeah, I get you. Anyway, I wanted to ask, what compartment is Lang in? Thought I'd go introduce myself properly, especially now I know he's Kat's boss.
He's in 1B, but hey, he told me he was going to take a nap. Asked me to wake him in an hour, so I'll give you a nod once he's up and about again.
Okay, cheers. Guess I'll go back to my room then.
You could head on down to the end. I bet Floyd would love to see a lovely young lady.
Floyd?
Bartender.
Floyd, the barman. Runs the bar. It's open, if you fancy a drink.
Yeah, a drink sounds good about now. Thanks, Don. You want anything?
Oh, I could go for some... What? No, better not. I fall asleep on my feet again. Nobody wants to see a conductor with bags under his eyes.
Okay, sure. Catch you later, Don.
He carries the bags, doesn't have them under his eyes. So yeah, she did... I was trying to say, that was a long dialogue there. I was trying to say that she got a... In the first installment of this, she got a, what do you call it? Message on her answering machine to go visit the museum or something like that.
When I saw him earlier, I thought he was old. But no, he just said, catch you later, Don.
Aye.
I shouldn't disturb random people. A compartment door. I can't hear anything.
So...
I have no... Old Gloria. Cute.
I was sure she said 1988,
Don
too.
Said I shouldn't disturb him yet, so I won't.
He was busy drowning in Earth from his window.
Lang's compartment. Apparently he's sleeping.
Oh, that's her compartment, right. So she was next door all this time. But when he went there was nobody there, just two big bags and a lantern and Victorian death photos. I think that was that room. It looks the same.
She looks weirdly like me.
Oh my,
uncannily,
really?
Uncannily so.
She does.
That's so cool. I should ask Dawn about her sometime. The canvas looks lumpy. Like there's something behind it.
Is there?
I have no reason to be pulling apart paintings. Besides, I can't do it with my bare hands. It's attached to the wall.
Undo it.
Nah.
Burn it.
Nah.
Nah.
Nah. Nah. She looks... The canvas...
Can't look under it?
She looks... The canth... I have no... She looks... The canth...
How do I leave again? Back? Oh, I can't... Alright, never mind.
They sound busy. I won't disturb them.
They? Who's in there?
A compartment door. I can hear the faint sound of talking from within. A fire extinguisher. Nothing's burning just... A compartment door. I can hear strange grunting. I'll, yeah.
Yeah.
They sound... yeah. No.
Now this grub, undead guy was in here.
The compartment door. I can hear faint, melancholy piano music from within.
Really?
Listening to the music makes me sad. I don't want to go in.
Is it the music currently playing?
If I remember correctly, this door should lead to the bar.
Righto. The food's not gross. Can't look at it, though. Yet.
Hello? Floyd? Anyone? No sign. Oh. Sounds like he's out back. I'll wait, then.
Can I look at stuff?
All the tables are laid with food. It still looks hot. Where are the diners?
Apparently grunting and stuff.
I'm not hungry. A window looking out into the night. The train's moving fast. I'd freeze to death if I opened the window. I'm not hungry. All the tables are...
Alright. There's a Bloody Mary there.
Just what I like to see. A well-stocked bar. Shame nobody's around to tend it. I can't reach over the bar.
Why not?
Oh, look. Someone's left a Bloody Mary lying around. I shouldn't. Should I?
It was, like, sparkling and everything. I guess we should. I don't think there's anything else to do. Unfortunately, I wonder what's actually in the drink.
Well, it is just sitting here. Wait, there's a note beside it.
Please drink this.
Alex, I thought you could use a drink. Steady your nerves. I'll be gone a while. Floyd. Well, that's thoughtful. No point waiting for Floyd in here, I guess.
How would he know?
Just what I like. I can't.
Alright, so we drank it. We don't have the glass or anything. Just checking.
I'm not hungry. All the
Okay, so now we're just leaving. Okay.
The door leading back to the second carriage.
Yes. Oh! Grub's door is open.
A compartment door.
Lydia? What? This is where Grub was.
Hi.
Hey.
Do you turn into Grub at some point?
When I'd free.
Music box. It wasn't a music box before.
There's only one bag here. Is this girl traveling alone? I'm not going to rummage through her bag right in front of her.
Yeah, we'll wait till she leaves first.
A music box. It's playing a beautiful, melancholy waltz. A lantern. A fairly typical one, as far as lanterns go. I shouldn't mess with it. I might upset her.
And she'll turn into a demon and kill you.
I have no need to carry a lantern around. A small girl dressed in a ballet outfit. She looks very sad. Hey, how are you doing, kiddo?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you, Mom?
Hey, call me Alex. I'm not old yet.
You're older than me.
True. What are you, 4? 5?
I'm 8, actually.
Oh, well, we're almost the same age then. You must be a big girl traveling alone this late at night.
Yep. I'm going to see my daddy.
Your daddy live in Nipawamset?
What a silly name. No, he doesn't live there.
Auger Peak?
Well, okay.
Is that where your daddy lives?
Actually, I lost my father. Tonight.
Is that why you look so sad?
That's the call she got.
No, actually.
Forgot.
He'd been suffering. It was better this way. I said my goodbyes already.
Grown-ups are weird.
Yeah, don't I know it. Anyway, let's not talk about that.
What do you want to talk about?
I want to talk about you.
Tell me about yourself. You travel alone a lot?
Uh-uh. First time.
I used to hate traveling alone. Hate it. I love it now. Weird, huh?
Why did you hate it?
It's nothing a kid needs to hear. Just lonely, angsty things.
Are you not lonely anymore?
No, I'm super lonely. I'm just at peace with that.
Grown-ups. Weird.
So, hey, you read comics?
Yeah. Well, a little.
I do. I love comics. I used to want to draw comics. Me and my friend Kat were gonna make one.
Why didn't you?
Life got in the way. You know how it is.
Grown-ups weird?
Actually, you're a kid. You probably don't.
Hey, I know a lot of things.
I'm sure you do, kiddo.
Ballet?
I used to do ballet, you know.
Really? You don't look like a ballerina.
Well, thanks, I guess.
I hate ballet. I keep trying and trying, but I don't get any better.
You seem pretty good to me.
No, I don't. I hate it.
Why do you keep doing it, then?
My daddy wants me to. He says it's a good way to meet other girls my age.
Oh, man. That takes me back. That's exactly why my dad pushed me into it, too. Didn't work, though. The other girls didn't like me. I was either a better dancer than them, which made them jealous, or a worse dancer than them, which made them tease me. In the end, I got thrown out of class for smashing one of the huge mirrors.
Maybe I should do that.
Don't go getting ideas, Missy. I'm a terrible role model.
I like your necklace.
Thanks. My boyfriend bought it for me.
Ex.
You have a boyfriend. Gross.
Actually, he's my ex-boyfriend. But there's nothing gross about it.
But boys are totally gross.
Yeah, I probably thought the same at your age. Trust me, you might change your mind, though. Sadly.
What was your boyfriend's name?
Gavin. Gavin Catrelli.
Oh.
He has a silly name.
First time I heard the last name.
He's a silly man. What's your name, by
He's a
way?
Silly man.
Lydia.
Well, great to meet you, Lydia. Anyway, I should leave you to your practice.
Okay. Come back and see me later.
Why don't we ask her where her parents are?
Come back and see me later, okay?
A small girl dressed in... I shouldn't. A music box.
Okay.
I'd freeze to death by... A wind... I'm not going to run... There's only one...
Yeah. Alright. She's a ghost. There's a ghosty ballerina.
Maybe I should go see Dawn. Ask if Lang's awake yet.
Okay.
A fire extinguisher. They sound... Yeah. No.
So I can go back in here, but why? So let's see if Lloyd's here, no.
I can't just what I like to see.
Yeah, never mind.
Maybe I should go see. They sound busy. A compartment door.
So my room is in here. Let me just check it. Still looks normal.
Dawn said I shouldn't just Lang's compartment. I shouldn't just a compartment.
So what's going on with Lang? He's dead? He's dreaming? He's dead but dreaming?
When I saw him earlier, I thought he was old. Hey!
Evening, miss.
Any sign of our doctor friend?
Well, I tried to wake him, but he was out cold. It seemed unkind to shake him awake.
Why would you?
I could go get some cold water if that'd help.
Can you imagine?
I'm imagining it now. And trust me, it's tempting.
Why is it tempting?
Anyway, Dawn, I wanted to ask you a question.
Well, ask away. But first, I have one on my own.
Why wake him
Shoot.
Up?
That's you called me by name just then. Why?
Isn't that what people do?
I never told you my name, Missy.
Oh no?
Pretty sure you did.
Reckon I didn't. Anyway, it's no matter. Just something to think on, is all. Maybe a little bird told you.
How strange. I'm sure you must have mentioned it. Anyway, I wanted to ask about that picture in the corridor. I noticed it as I went past.
You mean the one of Old Gloria?
No, the other one. The portrait. The young woman?
Yeah.
Oh, aye.
It looks like her.
Huh. Yep.
Who was she? I couldn't help but notice the similarities.
She's you.
Who?
Me? Don't say you can't see it.
Oh, aye. Now you mention it. She does bear a striking resemblance to you. Then again, you all look the same to me after I've had a drop of whiskey.
Who was she?
Flattering.
Don't rightly know. She came with Gloria. Maybe she's someone's daughter.
Well, yeah, I imagine she was. Most women are a daughter at some point.
Aye.
True.
You're a daughter, I imagine.
Yeah.
Grew up around your dad, did you?
Can we, like, not talk about my father right now? He kind of passed away very recently.
Oh, aye. Sorry, lass. I'm sorry for your loss.
It's okay. I knew it was time. He was my stepfather, but I loved him like a dad. He loved me like a daughter, too. At least up until he stopped recognizing me.
Hmm.
What about your mom? Are you and her still close?
Still?
Well, I assumed...
You assumed wrong. We were never close.
I'm sure that's not true now, lassie. I'm sure everything she did had your best interests at heart.
Doesn't mean they're close.
Hang on. You don't know anything about her. Or me, for that matter. Look, I'm sorry. This conversation's creeping me out, okay?
Oh, lassie. Balls. There we go. Into the tunnel. No idea why old Gloria craps out every damn time here.
Oh, Twilight Zone.
Settle down. We're in this for the long haul.
What? How long till the lights come back on?
We're in a tunnel?
Huge tunnel. Gonna be a good 15 minutes.
Oh boy.
I've got a candle here, but nothing to light it with.
Where's those lanterns? There's a lantern in the other room. There's a bunch of lanterns when we were playing the last installment.
When I saw him. Hey, you still there?
Aye.
So she can't see.
It's too dark to go fumbling about right now.
Oh, she needs...
It's too...
She can't do anything. She needs the lighter.
Here, use this lighter.
Oh, he needs a lighter.
Good work, lass. Must have given my matches to that funny fella in 2B. He likes to play with fire, so he does.
2B.
Well, that sounds astonishingly unsafe.
It's all right. I told him to be on his best behavior. It's not every day we have guests.
This is a passenger train.
Is it?
What?
What? Where the hell did he go?
That was not 15
Something's
minutes.
Something's not right about him. Something's not right about this place. Fuck it. I'm going to knock on Lang's door.
Jeez, I guess we are.
I probably shouldn't. This door leads to the engine. Actually, do I really want to know? Some kind of control panel for something on the train.
The shutters.
I'd better not tamper with the machinery. I shouldn't disturb random people. A compartment door.
Alright, I know we're supposed to go here to Lang, but... just want to check these compartments first.
I'd freeze to... We're moving fast.
That opens the shutters, the control panel. The shutters are already open. At least at this time they are. 2B plays with fire.
They sound busy. A compartment door. They sound... a compartment door.
This is where the ballerina girl is.
Huh. It's locked. Lydia? You in there? Lydia? Shit. I need to get the door open somehow. Lydia? Nah. Nah.
Alright, let's go check on Lang. Maybe he has something... Maybe he has the key for that. So Grub is in there otherwise. So who's Grub? Does she turn into Grub? Or is her father Grub? The one who wants her to be a ballerina.
It's locked. Lang's compartment. Apparently he's sleeping.
Oh, we wanted to go see him though. Alright, guess we're not seeing him yet. Sorry about that.
Nothing. A fire extinguisher.
Alright, I'm gonna check the bar, because I don't know what I can use to get in there. Oh, who's this?
Rob?
Oh, her friend
Alex,
Rob?
Alex, hello. You came. They said you would. You promised you'd call. You never called. Why didn't you call, Alex?
Rob, it's the middle of the night. Wait, what the fuck? Did you follow me here? Why are you on the goddamn train?
Oh, Alex, come on. I've always been there for you, haven't I? When Gavin left you, when your dad died, when you were getting those threatening phone calls.
So familiar.
Oh, God. I forgot about that.
Exactly. So why wouldn't I be here now when you need me again?
Because...
You're right.
You wouldn't know.
Okay, fuck it. Pretty sure I've passed out and I'm dreaming this, but whatever. I'll run with it. Why do I need you right now?
The earth crawls, Alex.
Oh, jeez.
The sepulchre thunders towards its destination, like worms burrowing through the soil. From the skies, the predator swoops. Zap! Feast upon the eyes of God. Darkness. Silence.
Okay, that's not a help.
Then a sudden scream pierces the night.
Oh, it does?
Rob, you're scaring me.
I'm sorry. I'm getting caught up in the moment. I should go back to my compartment. Come and find me there when you're done with the girl.
Lydia?
Huh?
I never told you about her.
I'm done with the girl.
Slice the girl away, Alex.
What?
Look at her insides.
Huh?
Put her belly. Find the key.
I don't want to do that. What compartment are you in?
The fuck? What the fuck is going on here? This is some... fucked up, trippy nightmare shit.
No kidding.
There's something on the table.
Which table? This table? Oh. Oh, a knife. Well, he wants us to cut apart the girl to get the key inside. What is this, saw or something?
A steak knife. It looks recently used. Oh, there's blood on it.
But whose blood?
I might need this.
We got it.
A steak knife.
Mm.
I'm not hungry.
You could cut into it with the steak knife.
Nah.
Or nah.
I can't read just what I like. I'm not hungry. All the tables are...
Okay. I really don't want to cut in some girl. Wasn't exactly high on my list of priorities.
Huh. It's locked. A compartment door.
Oh, that's not her. This is...
Nah. They sound...
Wait, this is where the girl was.
Huh. It's...
Now we're not calling for Lydia now.
A compartment door.
Isn't that where she was?
They sound... A compartment door. They sound... A compartment door.
Just checking the painting again, just in case anything changed. It looks the same.
She looks... Wait, the canvas... I have no reason to be pulling a...
Can we use the knife to go behind the...
Hmm. There's something here.
Yeah, what is that?
Weird. There's a key here. It says it's the key to 2A.
Whoa. He just said to slash open Lydia and get the key out of her belly. So that's what he meant. So wait, that's Lydia? Okay, so that's Lydia at a young age. She also was a ballerina at a young age, but didn't look the same. Didn't that girl have blonde hair? And, so her name is not Lydia, her name is Alex, unless she actually is Lydia, not Alex. I really don't know.
Oh my stars! Someone, some vile hooligan, some reprehensible villain has destroyed this priceless artwork.
Seriously?
My money's on Dr. Harold Lang. He has shifty eyes. That's what I'll say if anyone asks.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Here, I thought she forgot all about it.
I think it's fucked beyond all repair.
Okay, that's one way to put it.
It's the key to 2A. They sound
talking. Well, we're gonna find out who the hell is talking. Who cares if they're busy? Oh my, there's a lot of people here.
Hey. Hey, Alex. Hey, birthday girl. Where'd you get to?
Oh, they all did.
Sophia? Fuck. Jesus. Sophia, it is not my birthday. Why are you here?
Hey, you invited us, silly. Already drunk, I see.
What?
I've only had one Bloody Mary.